Good afternoon, welcome to Chopping It Up with Dennis DeCobra. Today we're going to continue a debate that started with some of my friends in a chat group. Randomly this morning, one of the guys asked if Michael Jordan's Bulls could be Clay and Steph's Warriors. A lot of banter back and forth, but to be honest, there's so many different variables, so I thought it would be good to fire up 2K, get on 2K, and we just kind of let the computer simulate it out. You know, they've accumulated all the stats, they've got all the algorithms, like, it's all in there. So rather than trying to debate it out, I kind of stopped and said, let's just see what will happen. What would 2K say? So we are about to get started. We're going to queue it up and kind of get going. I think we should give, since the, you know what, since the Bulls have way more championships, we should probably do the Bulls. So do we got 92-93 Bulls, the Cartwright, Grant. Let's see if we can find the one with the one in tow, one in question, was very specifically Rodman's Bulls. Rodman, Harper. We got Luke Longley in there. Y'all even remember who that is. Amateur. Sometimes we leave things out, man. It's a lot of good stuff happening in the NBA. I'm happy with the draft. You know, just looking, thinking like it's going to be pretty cool. All these young guys are fitting to take over. I think LeBron going to lead them right into the way to take over. Keep the league going nice and exciting. Still not that 90s NBA, but pretty good. So off top, we're looking at stat lines, matchups. It's kind of crazy. Steph Curry is a 95 versus Ron Harper as a 78. Klay at an 88 versus MJ a 99. Durant over Pippen. Rodman over Draymond, which we all agreed on. And then DeMarcus Cousins makes for a good, you know, matchup with Luke Longley, especially considering they have such a huge disparity between their stat lines. So, I don't know. Let's see what's happening. Do I want to change uniforms? Probably. You know what? I think we're going to go... Take them to the shy. All right. Teams are lined up. Game's tooted up. We'll get started. Let it simulate. We'll cut off a little bit after some of the action and come back. Make magic happen.
The regular season. It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello and welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Tonight, it'll be the Chicago Bulls up against the Golden State Warriors. Well, for Golden State, one of the things they'd like to accomplish is getting good shots. Maybe easier said than done. Defenses are quick to adapt, but they know that that's what gives them the best chance to win. Two great backcourts going head-to-head tonight. Kenny, your thoughts on how the guard position has evolved over time.
Well, I'm quick. Yeah.
The evolution of the guard position in 12 seconds, please.
Well, you aren't quick, so why do I have to be so quick?
Well, just try.
Okay, I'm going to be as quick as I can.
Okay.
So that I'm going to be
six
and five, as I can.
Okay.
Four, you know, three.
And more like combo guard.
Two, one.
And with all the switching guards in the minimal position, for the teams that rebound correctly, guards have to be a vulnerable voice.
That's almost like you were reading that, Shaq.
We were going to give you 10 seconds, Shaq. You're going to have to rush.
Yeah.
Good job, man.
Yeah.
Combo guards. Let's go forward, sir.
Nothing much going on that NBA pregame.
Kevin Harlan. It'll be the defending NBA champion, Golden State Warriors, and the Chicago
Golden State will get the first possession. Now Golden State's starting five. Durant and Green are the forwards. The tremendous pair of Curry and Clay in the backcourt. And it's Cousins at the foul spot.
And even with his range, that one might be asking a little too much.
Well, the truth is, he probably makes his shot a little more often than he should, so it's hard to resist.
A nice little way to take the early lead.
I see the effort already pushing to action, trying to establish a presence.
Now here's Thompson. Outside Curry. Goes up on the wing, and it's in there.
Stephen Curry is great off the dribble, but he also is good at the catch and shoot.
Pippen with it. About a minute played so far here in the first. To the inside. Jordan. Right on the bucket.
And the perils of trying to defend Jordan. Athletic enough to get anywhere he wants to go. And then tough enough to take the hit and finish.
Curry outside. And out of bounds in Chicago in possession.
No.
So as you can see, first half, first quarter is over, pretty close. It was pretty evenly matched throughout. Nothing I don't think anyone would, you know, wouldn't expect. Steph did start to light it up, though. So.
Then there's DeMarcus Cousins and Livingston in a shooting guard position. Simpkins passes to Kukoc. It doesn't go for him. And Golden State will come the other way. One is checked in for Wednesday.
See what it's looking like. To me, it looks like a pretty entertaining game, but we know this debate's gonna go on forever. We know it's gonna happen. The old heads are never gonna stop, and the young guys are gonna become old heads, and it'll be the same debate for them over and over and over again. So we're gonna let this thing ride on out. see what it looked like, talk about it again.
Defensively coming in, you know he's because he got hot as much as it's because of the effort he put in to get himself open. 1:15 left in the fourth quarter of this one.
1:58 left. They gave Stephen Curry the player of the game.
Warriors with the rebound.
We all know Jordan would have missed that shot.
Durant wide open, he fires. And he gets the friendly spin, that one drops. Now it's a 7-point Warrior lead.
54, Golden State. Shot better from the field, shot better from the three. Not by much, but yeah, enough. Well, folks, there you have it. So, based on 2K's algorithms, based on all of the details and data that's in 2K, they show Golden State coming out on top. Now, I'm watching this game. I ate some good food, but that's not important right now. What's important is there are a lot of things that did happen that I didn't think would happen in real life. Like, there were a couple shots that Pippen missed, a couple shots MJ missed that I don't think would have happened. There also were a couple shots Curry didn't hit that I think would have happened, as well as a little bit of the ball holding a little too much. I don't know. But I think the transition game from the teams is what made the difference. And both teams played exactly like you would remember. Golden State shot, and they shot, and they shot them threes. But even though they did in the beginning, MJ and Pippen and them guys, they really went through and did the way that they would play. So it was pretty cool to see that they didn't try to make Chicago shoot like the current NBA is. But nonetheless, you know, the debate continues. No matter what I say on this, there's someone who may agree, may not. It's all good. As long as it's good, fun, and healthy. Until next time.